Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. We're so glad you could attend. Come inside, come inside. There behind the glass stands a real blade of grass. Be careful as you pass. Move along, move along. Come inside, the show's about to start. Guaranteed to blow your head apart.
In the fall of 2001, Manchester, New Hampshire unveiled a new crown jewel. The Verizon Wireless Arena was a sparkling addition to the city and the region, where on November 16th, a capacity crowd of 10,057 watched as the Manchester Monarchs made their historic American Hockey League debut. The Manchester Monarchs made their mark that November evening. Defenseman Joe Corbo scored the first home goal in Monarchs history, and goaltender Travis Scott made 28 saves, sending a message that would echo throughout the American Hockey League and the Granite State. The Monarchs captured their first of many home victories, defeating their division rival, the Lowell Lock Monsters, by a score of 3-1.
Welcome to the jungle. We got fun and games.
The Monarchs, who had begun the season with a grueling 13-game road trip, surged during the ensuing months, playing especially well in front of the home crowd and asserting themselves among the elite teams in the American Hockey League. The Monarchs won 8 of their first 10 home games, quickly making the Verizon Wireless Arena one of the most difficult venues in the league in which to play.
I want to watch you bleed. Welcome to the jungle. We're taking day by day.
New Hampshire's hockey fans responded to their new team in a big way, placing Manchester third among AHL cities in average attendance. Along with world-class hockey action on the ice, Monarchs fans were treated to a night of total entertainment at each and every home game. There is always plenty for everyone to see and enjoy in a Monarchs game, providing a quality entertainment atmosphere for hockey enthusiasts, families, and businesses alike. General Manager Kevin Gilmore, Director of Hockey Operations Hubie McDonough, and Head Coach Bruce Boudreau have built a highly competitive team. Veteran Ted Donato arrived in Manchester, providing an offensive punch, and along with Captain Dane Jackson, brought leadership and NHL savvy to the young team. UNH alum Derek Pecker, who scored 27 goals in 2001-2002, has been a catalyst to the Monarchs' offense. And All-Star Travis Scott has been rock solid in goal, including 3 straight shutouts in December of 2001. Enforcers Kip Brennan, Ryan Flynn, and Joe Roulier set a tone for hard work and toughness that give the Monarchs all the makings of a Calder Cup contender.
One of the things we preach is once you put on the sweater, it means work and never give up.
While the team was winning games on the ice, they were also winning the hearts and admiration of the community. Monarchs Care Foundation, the team's charitable organization, was launched to ensure that the team has a positive impact on the community with a special emphasis on families and children. Partnering with organizations like the United Way, Special Olympics, and the Boys and Girls Club, Monarchs Care organizes and takes part in many notable activities each year. New Hampshire fans have welcomed the Monarchs with a roar of approval, and the team's commitment to hard work, excitement, and family entertainment makes them a perfect fit for the Granite State. From their opening night forward, the Monarchs have established a winning tradition both on and off the ice.